I can't remember who sang it now. It sounded like her. So I won't sing it. It was going around in my head. Glory be to God. So if you have not registered, I beg you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Go and register. Hello? Mr. Meg, have you registered? Where are you voting? I hope it's not your village. They are going to your village. Where you live? No, but you are not allowed to travel within town. You can't drive. And you should not be trekking to a far place. You should just be... There's the way they've done it, there's a pulling boat within 10 minutes or thereabout from where you live. So if your pulling boat is more than 10 minutes, 15 minutes, if it's going to 20 minutes, then you are in the wrong pulling boat. Praise the Lord. Maybe they created a new one closer to you, you didn't know. Please check. Okay? Hello? Benjamin, have you registered? Huh? So you are looking at me like St. Peter and St. Paul. When are you going to register? You don't want to register. When? If you go to Eligbolo, I hear it's very, very crowded. But Oginigba is freer. Okay? So find out the place in Oginigba. To find out... Rumasi has one. I'm talking of Oginigba. Is Rumasi own? Is it easy? That Rumasi, I don't trust it. They don't look like they are easy. But you can check Rumasi, but Eligbolo is very, very crowded. And of course, if you go to Inec headquarters, you're on your own. The last time somebody went to, she had not registered. She registered online just to do her biometrics. It is from the gate they blocked all of them. And they told them, sorry, go. So whether INEC is party to people not registering, I don't know. What do they get if people don't register? So, 1, 2. Who else has not registered? Who wants to do change of pulling boots? So, wait, we'll do it today. Okay? Today. Hallelujah. Praise God. How can we be talking about election in church? But we pray about it, don't we? So if we can pray about it, why can't we talk about it? The Bible says we should pray for... You know, the Christians that were in Germany during the time of Hitler, I sorry for them. What kind of prayer would they be praying for Hitler? You don't want to get to that stage. Bible pray for leaders that may lead a godly and peaceable life. What do you want to pray for Hitler about? Oh Lord, remove him. That's the only prayer. Using human beings to make soap, is that a good thing? Glory be to God. So don't let us get there that we're praying, Lord, remove. It is better, you know, if you have ever had to do renovation, you'll find that renovation is very hard. To build fresh is very simple. But to renovate, hey! When you fix one thing, you find out because you fix this one, something else has gone bad. It's not funny. Praise the Lord. So we do not want repackaged and rebagged things. We want Ororo. Glory be to God. So that the blessing will come. Glory be to God. All right. So I have, you wait, two of you, and then two of you, and anybody else. Okay, you want to change? I thought you did it last week. Okay, we'll do it today. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. I have become INEC official. A holy INEC official. You know, there are some ministries who have given targets. People must register. And this is not a joke. And some, even some churches, your gate pass is your PVC. No PVC, no enter. It sounds funny. And some people have actually taken offense at it. That what is that? Can't go and worship God. Is it by force you will vote? Okay, let me tell you why it's by force you will vote. You are the person that will say, I have a right as a citizen. This is the number one right as a citizen. To determine who leads the country. The Bible says, let me use pidgin English. I'm sorry for you. If your leaders, during the daytime, they should be governing, they are busy shacking. That's what the Bible says. You know, if your leaders are shacking during the daytime, you people are finished. So if you don't want leaders that are shacking during the daytime, you know, I work in an organization where you are not allowed to drink alcohol until close of work. Even when you go for a social gathering representing the company. Hello? You cannot drink alcohol. Let's assume you go for a meeting in presidential hotel. Yeah? And then they bring people are taking, you will still hold your body. You can't take alcohol. Have you been to some of our state functions? There's what is called discipline. How people conduct themselves. It shows how far they will go. And I was reading an article about different cultures, particularly relating to work. You know, in Nigeria, we are very polite, and I can't seem to get rid of it. I don't know that it's being polite or whatever. So when I'm writing an email, I start with good day. And then I'll write what I want to write. But I've noticed that a lot of people who are from Europe, they just say, Trevor, where is this thing? It's finished. They don't have time for good day. Now, if you call a German during work time, and oftentimes you have to call his work phone, you can't call his private phone. If you call a German during work time, say, John, or they'll call themselves Johan, where did you keep the file? Where is it saved? You know, you don't say, Johan. How was your ninth? He will ask you, what has my ninth got to do with you? Hello? You know, here we say we are being polite. We say, how was your ninth? Did you sleep well? So what has that got to do with you? A German goes to work on time. He closes on time. Woe betide you to call a German after work hours to say work. They will report you. Yes, and you will be queried. Yes, you are not allowed to. In fact, the French want to adopt it. You are not allowed to. Praise God. They work. So when they are working, they are not looking at Facebook. Praise the Lord. They work. When they go to play, they go to play. And the Bible agrees with it. There's a time for everything. Hallelujah. Praise God. I remember a Nigerian minister said, look, if you work in my office and then you resume 8 o'clock, you pray from 8 to 9, I will fire you. So you are in my office to work, not to pray. But if part of your work is prayer, like those who work in church, then that's acceptable. But I will have to call the Lord. See, God is not like you think he is. You are actually cheating your employer. God is not like you think he is. So let me just say this. Those of you who sneak to a church program when you're supposed to be working is wrong. The thing to do is take permission. Use your leave days. You have leave days, don't you? take 1 or 2 days off work and attend the program. Give unto Caesar what is Caesar's, and to God what's God's. Hallelujah. Praise God. All right. So some of you be wondering. Hello? So we're talking about keeping your heart. And last week we talked about, we read Matthew chapter 5 verse 8. We did, let's read it. Jesus talking, and there are things that we looked at. He said, blessed, happy are the pure in hearts, for they shall see God. So we pure in hearts, the reward is you see God. Praise the Lord. Hello. Glory be to God. Let me read a scripture. 1 John. 1 John chapter 3. I was saying I would just read verse 3, but let's just go from verse 1. Behold what manner of love the Father had bestowed upon us, that we should be called the sons of God. Therefore the world knoweth us not, because it knew him not. Verse 2. Behold, beloved, now are we the sons of God, and it does not yet appear what we shall be, but we know that when he shall appear, hallelujah, we shall be like him, for we shall do what? Okay. Go back to verse 1. You know, I've read this scripture in a particular manner before. I wanted to look at something. Behold, beloved, now are we what? It does not yet appear what we shall be, but we know that when he shall appear, who? Well, who shall appear? Did he talk about the sons of Jesus? Hello? You know, one of the things we jump to Jesus because we see the word appear. And we think about it like the rapture. Is that what the scripture says? Hello? Is that what the scripture says? Did he say anything about rapture? It says we are who? The sons of God. It does not yet, we don't see how we will be yet. But we know that when he shall appear, we shall be like what? For we shall see him as he what is. Who have we not seen? Who have we not seen? Who have we not seen? We've not seen the Father. The Bible says, Jesus said, for he has declared him. But we haven't seen him. No eye has seen him. Praise the Lord. Because he says he dwells in an inapproachable light. Hello? Verse 3. And every man that had this hope in him does what? Even as he is. Okay, so go back to Matthew 5:8. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall what? God is pure. To see him, you have to be pure. Hello? So if you're not pure, if you are not ororo, no see God. He didn't say blessed are those who are born again. To be born again, you want to say one thing, you have to say plenty of things to be able to say one thing. It's very difficult. verse 13, Titus chapter 2. Looking for the blessed hope and the glorious appearing of who? Okay. And what? Okay. You know, you can read the scripture to mean that Jesus is our great God, and you know, you can, most times you read it that way. But it's talking about God, our great God, then our Savior Jesus as two distinct. Do you understand? And which word did he use for God again? The appearing. We are now able to what? Perceive him. And to perceive him, what is the requirement? Purity. Hello? Verse 14, we make it clearer. Go to verse 14. Now, who gave himself? Jesus. That he might redeem us from what? All iniquity. And he purified unto himself a peculiar people. What? Zealous. So Jesus qualified us to see the Father. He redeemed us from all iniquity and purified us. He cleansed us. Kathatos. He washed us. He made us clean. So Jesus said, hey, when a man is on the earth and he goes out and comes in, he does not need to wash everywhere. All he needs to do is wash his feet. Abi? Because it's his feet used to communicate with the earth. So, because you're on earth, the environment contaminates. Praise the Lord. So if the environment contaminates, you have a need to purify yourself. But you have been purified, you've been made clean. But because you are in a contaminated environment, you need to consistently purify yourself. Glory be to God. So if you are not purified, see, don't get it mixed up that because you're saved, that is sufficient. It is the beginning. Hello? It is the beginning. Because as we interact with the world, impurities are introduced. And those impurities can make you not make heaven. Glory be to God. Did it bother you when Jesus said, many are called, few are chosen? One. Then he said, narrow is the way that goes to life. And he didn't say people are struggling to enter. He said, few there be that what? He didn't say walk in it, that find. To even find the way, there are few. But he said, broad is the way to destruction, and there be many what? Multitude. Express way. And they are all following. Praise the Lord. When you get to the road, you must walk according as the road is designed. You must know the way of God. He says, look, know my way and walk in it. Say, where you are coming from, my way is not like your way. You cannot use your way to walk in my kingdom. That's disqualification. You cannot play football with volleyball rules. Hello? That is automatic what? Every time you just be foul, 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 foul. After the foul is too much, they give you red card. But that's what we want to do a lot of times. You know, one of the things I began to see was, if you want to be rich in this life, you can't do it according to the ways of the world. You have to do it according to the way of God. And God has no quarrel with the best person being rich. In fact, he says, if you only let me help you, I'll make you rich. But that richness comes from him, his type. Because he said to Joshua, you will have good success. That means there is bad success. Hello? If there's good success, there's bad success. Hallelujah. So not everybody that says they are rich, they sit in church, so the Lord has blessed me. And you ask him, what do you do? And he begins to tell you, he does oil stealing and refining. How is that a blessing? You are a thief. And you are a killer. You are polluting the atmosphere to kill people. And you are singing praise to God, so the Lord has done me well. He does bless me. You are a thief. Call a spade a spade. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. God says, because you don't have access to steal. I never have access to steal. I'm even praying against having the access. Glory be to God. They say, you are talking because you've never seen money. You never deal with the see money. You are joking. There are things that you do before you get to see evil. Such that when you see evil, you are not tempted. If you think the day evil comes to you is the day you should have prepared, you have failed. Hello? So some of us, there are some things that we have done. We have finished. We are waiting for the opportunity for evil to come. When it comes, you will find that no vacancy. Hello? Some people are praying. Let those opportunities come. I will hammer. When I hammer finish, I'll repent. Let me read one scripture. Galatians. Yes, my scripture. Galatians chapter. Open up. Sharp. Chapter 5. One verse. Verse 9. A little what? You know we like leaven. You know, in Nigeria, we don't eat unleavened bread. Except you're eating shawarma. So we like leaven. And you know, God is interesting. You know, you've heard of the Feast of Unleavened Bread. Okay, so why was there a Feast of Unleavened Bread? It was not because God did not want to eat bread that was leavened. It was because they were in a hurry to leave Egypt. And they could not wait for the dough to rise. So God commemorated Feast of the Unleavened Bread. So Passover, you must eat unleavened bread. But more importantly, God did not allow leaven in any of the offerings that he gave. Because leaven is a corruption. It changes from the natural state. It's an introduction of something that changes. It causes a growth that was not there, that is not intrinsically from the dough. Praise the Lord. So God forbade all leaven from his offering. So if you think doing one bad thing, you just do it and you just escape. Have you ever wondered, guys who have been stealing money for the past 40 years, they still have not stopped? Because you would think, if I just go, I just hammer, I just come out, no more. You just say, let me just go again. Before you know, you have gone 40 times. A little leaven, leavened the whole lump. And God does not want leaven in your life. So when you walk the earth, the atmosphere pollutes. There's leaven everywhere. And you must get rid of that leaven. You know, when we're talking about evil, we talked about evil in its natural state. Huh? The devil brought evil. Then we talk about evil that is a consequence of corruption. Then evil that is just in the atmosphere. Whether you like him, you don't like him, evil is there. Do you understand? You don't have to do anything wrong for evil to look for you. Praise God. You go to the hospital hoping to get good medicine. But this hospital wants to cut corner. They want to charge you high money and get fake drugs. And they give you. And it brings another thing entirely to your life. Didn't you pay? Did you pay for you to have more sickness? It's what is in the world. Praise God. You go to buy a car engine, and this fellow swear to you that he got it directly from Mercedes-Benz AG in Germany. And then he shows you on that one, say this one is Tokumbo, they do something. And then you pay for it only to get there, they fix it. 3 days later, your engine is smoking Joe. And you go to him and say, "Now so we see him." Hello? But you have spent good money. That's evil. God never wants us to make a loss. Because loss is not with God. Everything God does increases. But loss removes from you. Do you understand? And that's the devil. The glory that Adam had, when he came, he lost it. The Bible says, and he saw that they were naked. Were they not naked before? But the glory covered. Now the glory lifted. The one that was clothed with the same raiment as God now had to use leaves. Do you understand? So a little leaven, just a small thing, small. It's a slippery slope. Very slippery. Very, very slippery. It's better not to start than to start. So because you're on earth, and these impurities lock everywhere, and number one impurity, Jesus was very clear. He said in chapter 15, verse 19 of Matthew, where do these things come from? We are talking about keeping your heart, Abby. Say, from out of the heart proceeded what? So, thoughts. Impure thoughts are a problem. Praise the Lord. They are a problem. But impure thoughts are not even the foundation. Hello? They are not the foundation. The foundation is basically where you put your eyes. Hello? So Jesus said in Matthew 6, let's read from verse 19. Lay not up for yourselves what? Upon the earth. Where moth and rust doth do what? Okay. You have treasures. The moth corrupts it. So they are there to corrupt it. If you cook sumptuous meal and you leave it on the table, you have unwanted guests. Flies will come. What will you first do? Make sure there's no fly around. Praise the Lord. Unwanted. But there's corruption in there. You leave that food, after a while, worms will come out of it if you don't eat it in time. Praise God. You know, the way I look at it, I don't think fruits of themselves, when they are plucked, would decay when God first made them. Hello? He called it good, so it cannot be bad suddenly. Praise God. It was because of the corruption. So he says, lay not where there's corruption, where thieves break through and steal. Glory be to God. Verse 20. But lay up where? For yourselves, treasure where? In heaven. Where neither moth nor rust doth corrupt. Where thieves do not break through nor steal. For where your treasure, where your focus is, your heart will be there. Your treasure is the thing that you prize most. Anything you prize, your heart will follow. Hello? Now, you say, but okay. heart, mind. Huh? Heart and mind. So what's the difference between heart and mind? It's very blurry, but I think we explained it one of the service. The faculty to make choices and to choose. Huh? The heart in lay terms is you. You, the real you, not this beating one, the real you. So the choices are within you. The ability to make a choice is within you. You know, in the human body, we say the brain is here, and that's where you think. And they even say if you are thinking about certain things, some part will light up. When you are thinking about other things, some part will light up. So it is in the spirit. Praise the Lord. So the things you have chosen, you will your whole human person, not this clothes now, because this clothes will be carried by the one inside. When I mean clothes, I mean the flesh. So the person on the inside, once that choice is made, begins to go there. This one just follows naturally. It just follows. Because this one really is just a messenger. But this one also can cry. In fact, his own cry is very annoying. It is the most strident. This thing is the loudest noisemaker. You know, if you have pain in your heart, your spirit, if your spirit is broken, you are sad, you know, you can mask it. If nail pierce your foot, no masking. You will dance at Jasco. You will shout, everybody will know, because you'll be doing like this. Abby, everybody will know. So this body, he can act up. He's an actor. This body is Mary Johnson. That lady can act. Hallelujah. Or rather, you look with the eye. Huh? So that's what brings information. Huh? So he says, let your eye be single. But we know we are not cyclops. We have two eyes, yeah? If his single is filled with light, then he says, let your, verse 23. He said, but if thy eye be evil, aha, how can it be evil? But I thought it was the light. So there is good eye and there's bad eye. Praise the Lord. And if you have bad eye, there's only darkness. If therefore the light that is in thee is darkness, how great is that darkness? You can't even see, you're just groping in the dark. Hallelujah. No man can serve two masters, for either he will hate the one. This is fundamental. Either will hate the one and love the other, or else he will hold to the one and despise the other. You cannot serve God and mammon. It is not you may not, You cannot serve. What does it mean to serve? To wait upon. Huh? To look for a command from somebody. Hello? That's what it means to serve. If you serve Mammon, and Mammon particularly was talking about the God that they serve, that they claim brings money. Huh? And that God is mean. You know, any demon, they like to chop blood. Not just ordinary blood, human blood. They like to do bad things. Praise the Lord. Now, if you want to get money, the Bible says, do not strive to be rich. Say, because in trying to be rich, you enjoy yourself. Praise God. So in trying to serve Mammon, to wait for Mammon to make you rich, because the Bible says it is God that gives you power to get wealth. But if you cannot wait on God to give you power to get wealth, if you cannot follow his way, because God's way is very, very interesting. He says a little here, a little there. You cannot be drinking Gary and palm kernel today. Eh? And then tomorrow, you have 20 billion in your account. First of all, you will go mad. That's the truth. And God doesn't want you to go mad. And that's why you see a lot of people, when they come into sudden wealth, all the evil that is inside of them begins to appear. Because money is an amplifier. But as God takes you through step, you will be cleaning. You will be cleaning. Because when you really hold cocos, Jesus said, if you don't know how to take care of another man's thing, who will give you true riches? When they put true riches in your hand and you are perverted, it takes on your character. Because he says, a rich fool spoils much good. Only one thing. You just spoil many things. So who are you serving? Are you serving God or you are serving Mammon? Where is your devotion? Glory be to God. Where is your focus? Where is your devotion? Are you keenly, you know, a lot of times growing up, when they say, oh, serve God, then let your, it didn't make much meaning to me. But as I began to study, it starts from why you are, what's your purpose? What are you? What's your purpose? I was made for his pleasure. Praise God. God made me for his pleasure. When I realized that, my purpose is to please him. If my purpose is to please him, and he says, this pleases me, I do it. If he says, this does not please me, I don't do it. Praise the Lord. My choices are restricted to the things that please him. Do you understand? So I don't wander into thinking, but let us try that. That is like looking for the forbidden fruit. Do you understand? So in your head, in your life, not the one we see, the one inside, where's your focus? Where's your devotion? Where do you spend time? Where do you spend time? In your mind, where do you spend time? Don't you spend time in your mind? Where do you spend that time? What do you do with that time? Are you focused on God? Do you meditate on him? Because he tells Joshua, he told him, he said, meditate upon this thing, ruminate upon them, so you make your way prosperous. Keep thinking about them. Keep thinking about them. Those things are what shapes you. So where do you spend time? If you spend time with God, you'll be filled with light. If you spend time with the world, glory be to God. So let's read, where are we? Where's 1 John chapter 2, verse 15. Read a couple of verses. It says, love not what? Neither what? The things that are in the world. Okay. What things are in the world? Mercedes Benz, 100-inch flat screen. Cavier. Those are the things in the world. They are not in heaven. There is no television in heaven. I hope you know. Some people can divorce if you spoil their television. My car! I was saying to your father's house, you touch my car. Just tell me that you are a bum boy. Because if the best car in your house should be driven by the woman. Hello? You know what I said? All you men that are driving better cars than your wife, shame on you. The best car should be driven. Okay, some of you say my car is finer than the one Pastor Faye drives. She gave it to me. I don't have a car. So let me just tell you now from the beginning. The car that I have, she gave it out. So she then gave me one to be driving. Praise the Lord. I am not constrained by the things that are on earth. You see. Jesus Christ said, the Son of Man does not have a place to lay. He said, I don't. I'm just bunking with her. You see? Hallelujah. Glory be to God. So just free yourself. Say the things that are in the world. If any man love the world, the love of the Father is not in him. I'd like for you to note that the person talking is John. He is the disciple that Jesus loved. Hello? And if you note, he's a love apostle. He talks about love more than anybody. So he said, if you love the things that are in the world, how you want to wear your Lobotin? Huh? You want to wear your Giorgio Armani suits? You want the accolades of men. Those things are so important to you. You will practically nearly kill somebody for stepping on your $10,000 shoes. You will nearly kill the person. Say, do you know how much I bought it for? One finger of that person is more than it. Say, you are not even walked up to my shoe. You are a liar. There is nothing on earth that equates to one human person. Hello? Not all the gold in the world equates to one human person. Praise the Lord. But that's where your attention is. Verse 16. For all that is in the world, the lust of the flesh and the lust of the eyes and the pride of life is not of the Father, but is of the world. And the world passeth away, and the lust thereof. But he that doeth the will of God abideth forever. So if you are moved by these things, if your devotion is these things, you do not, everything must be brought to God. And you will look at it with the eyes of God. If you look at it any other way, your devotion will not be on God. It is the value that God gives a thing that is the real value. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. I was, ministers are very interesting. Oh, should I say this? Okay, let me say it. I was flipping through, I can't remember what I was reading, and a young minister was upbraiding a Nigerian gospel singer who was engaged to a pastor, and that minister said because they are giving rings, that is, in fact, they say she won't go to heaven or something, I can't remember what he said. And then he quoted the scripture I read to you in Isaiah, about rings and nose ring. And I wondered, I asked myself, is this guy daft? Is he daft? Did God say he hated them? God said, because this is where your pride is, because you are looking shingere and doing like this. He said, I will remove it so that you'll be naked. Which means God knows that thing is fine. He clothed you. But here was the man saying because God hated it, that's why I removed it. Oh, God didn't say so. So you will imagine that fellow teaching people. Like I said to you, if you can afford it, wear nose ring, wear waist ring, wear leg ring, wear neck ring, wear everything you like. We'll be hailing you that God is blessing you. Anybody that does not like it, they must like it. Praise God. You see, if God likes it, who are you not to like it? Who are you? Whatever God likes, I like. Glory be to God. Whatever God condemns, I don't even condemn it. I don't even think about it. Because to think about it, I might go and be questioning. I don't want to think about it. Glory be to God. So your devotion, my time is running off. So the first thing to keep impurities away, your devotion must be centered on God. Do you understand? If you read 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 18, it says, looking where? That's Hebrew. We will get there. First of all, he says, why we look not where? So, you know, some scriptures did not make sense to me until you begin to put some things together. He said the things that are in the world, you should not look at them. Abi? So you shouldn't look at them. So he says, we don't look at the things that we see. Where do we look? The things which are not seen. Those things which are apprehended by faith. Those things that which are of God. Because if you persistently look at the Mercedes Benz, your attention will go there. And let me tell you how your attention will go. Here you are. They told you the new SLK is 45 million naira. And you don't really have 45 million naira cash, so you're saving for it. And you have made 42 million. And then church comes up and says, hey, we have a need. A family fell into misfortune. And we need to get them a house. The house will cost 1 million naira for rent. And then we need to make it up, put some things, you know. And everything, we need 3 million. You just throw your eye, they're not talking to me. Why? SLK. You are looking at what? SLK. You are not looking at the things which are not seen. You see that? Because doing to this one, Jesus said, you've done unto me. But you will elevate the car more than this one. You say, there are other people now. There are other people now. There are no other people, you. You must do first before other people. You can't hold other people to do. The word is to you, not to other people. Okay. Receive! It's from you. Give! Oh, that's somebody. You see how crooked you are. You are a crook. That's why Paul said, purify your heart. James, say, you sinner. Say, purify your heart. That's why I said it. Because people are like that. They are like that. They look at things that they can see. For the things which are seen are what? Temporal. That Mercedes Benz, by next year, they'll make another one. It will become old model. But the things which are not seen are eternal. They have eternal value. They are not outmodeled. The same yesterday, today, and always. And it brings reward, not for just this life, but for the one to come. You can't take your car or your house out of here. In fact, you can't take it out of the grave. They won't even put it in the grave. I know somebody, they buried him with a jeep. What a fool. And it's people from this side, though, that are doing those things the most. You know when I say this side? What a fool. You know, in Ashanti, what we learned it in the, when we're doing the history of Ghana, they bury the what they call their name, Ashanti, whatever. They bury them with all kinds of things. So they say when he goes to the next life, so that he will not be poor. So they will start to magically will come to get to the spiritual. Okay, continue. How many times have you seen a witch fly from Benin to Calabar to go home meeting with earpiece? They just go. Hello? They just go. They don't need earpiece. Over there, no earpiece. They have their own. When Philip moved from, when he went to Azotus from the desert, did he look for British Airways? Continue. I like that Airways that carried Philip. And that is instant. They're here today, they're here the next minute. Boom, boom. Not sit in the, you go sit at the airport, you sit in the plane, say, have we not reached? You look, Britain stiffer. Have we not reached? No. This one, you want to be there, you are there. And then came Jesus in their midst. I like that kind of plane. Glory be to God. That's what we look for. We are not looking for Lufthansa. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. It is important that your focus don't be on. Some of you, you plan the clothes you wear to church. You are careful to wear fine clothes. Blessed be your name. But you're not careful to get good offerings. Your clothes are ironed, but your offering is not ironed. It's rumpled. In fact, it's dirty. Why don't you wear dirty clothes to church, but you come and give dirty money to God? Shame on you. Better do transfer. We don't want to see your dirty notes. Hello? You know, I learned a long time ago, when I give cash, I will straighten all of it out. And it's easier to count. I will straighten it. I will look for the clean ones. Some people are specialists in giving patched money in church. God is looking at you. You see what he told people in Malachi? Okay. I dey watch you. Go and give your governor goat with one eye and see what he will do to you. That's what you do to God. God is watching you. He's watching you. He's saying, this one, I will use him one day, no believer. One day, small thing you do like this, an angel will just slap you. God say, give him. And he's got, I hope you know that God beats people. He's just waiting. Because this is your foolishness need to be corrected before you go to hell. Glory be to God. I love God. Do you love God? Wholehearted devotion.